Hey everybody, this video is going to discuss how to play and win the game of NIM. This is a very simple game to learn, and seeing how a winning strategy is derived by converting it to a mathematical model is quite enlightening. The basic game consists of a finite group of markers laid out into rows with any number of markers you wish in each row. In the diagram here, we have 16 markers in 4 rows with 1, 3, 5, and 7 markers respectively. This particular arrangement is known as the Marienbad pattern, after the otherwise forgettable movie Last Year at Marienbad. The rules are simple. The players alternate turns. On each turn, a player can remove as many markers as they wish, but only from a single row. The player that takes the last marker wins. The name NIM most likely originated from the German word NIM, which means to take. Here's a sample game using the Marienbad pattern. Player 1 takes 2 markers from the 4th row. Player 2 responds by taking all 3 markers on the 2nd row. Now player 1 takes 2 markers from the 3rd row, and player 2 takes 2 markers from the 4th row. Player 1 takes 1 marker from the 4th row, and player 2 takes the remaining 3 markers from the 3rd row. Now player 2 is forced to win. Player 1 must choose one of the remaining markers, and whichever he chooses, player 2 chooses the other marker and wins. The theory we're about to describe was developed by Charles Boutain of Harvard back in 1901. Another historical note worth mentioning is that Westinghouse converted NIM into one of the world's first computer games called Nimitron, which it demonstrated at the 1940s World's Fair. You might have noticed that player 2 won our sample game by forcing a final balanced game of 1v1. The idea of balance is in fact the root of our winning strategy. Suppose we had the game pictured here with only 2 rows. Player 1 could force a win by removing 2 markers from the bottom row, creating 2 balanced rows. Now, whatever player 2 does, player 1 just has to copy that for the other row. Eventually, player 2 will have to eliminate a row, and then player 1 eliminates his row and wins. So a game of NIM with only 2 rows is easily won by being the first person to balance the rows. But suppose we have more than 2 rows. How do we generalize this idea of a balanced game when we have many rows involved? The secret to this requires an understanding of the binary number system. Humans are typically endowed with 10 fingers and 10 toes, so we developed our earliest number system based off the number 10. The decimal system has 10 digits, those being 0 through 9, and each decimal position corresponds to increasing powers of 10. In other words, if we had 1,475 marbles, we could break this into one group of 1,000, 4 groups of 100, 7 groups of 10, and finally 5 groups of 1. The binary number system, on the other hand, is based on the number 2. There are 2 binary digits, or bits, those being 0 and 1. When we write a number in binary, like 1101, each position corresponds to an increasing power of 2. So, for example, if we had 13 marbles and we wanted to break those up into powers of 2, we could make one group of 8, one group of 4, no groups of 2, and then one group of 1. So the decimal number 13 is equivalent to the binary number 1101. Here's another example with 27 shaped, star-shaped markers. The largest power of 2 we can form is 16, so we put a 1 in the 16th place. That leaves us with 11. Of those remaining, we can make one group with 8, which leaves us with 3 markers. We can't make a group of 4, but we can make a group of 2, and as before, that leaves us with one group of 1. So the binary number for 27 is 11011. Now we're ready. The trick is to convert each row to a binary number. That is, each row should be broken up into groups of increasing power of 2. Here's an example of our Marienbad pattern. Our first row has only 1 marker, so a group of 1 is the only possibility. The second row has 3 markers, so we can do a group of 2 and a group of 1. Our third row has 5, so we can do a group of 4 and a group of 1. You can't have repeated groups in a row, so a group of 2, 2, and 1 would not be acceptable. And finally, our fourth row with 7 can be represented as a group of 4, 2, and 1. We'll say that our game is balanced if every power of 2 group is balanced by a matching group in another row. In other words, we want to have an even number of rows containing each power of 2. Notice that our Marienbad pattern starts out in a balanced state, since we have 2 groups of 4, 2 groups of 2, and 4 groups of 1. Since we have an even number for each group, the game is balanced. An even number equals 0 in mod 2 arithmetic, so having a balanced game is also referred to as having a NIM sum of 0. An alternate way to think of this would be to write the binary representation for each row. In order for the game to be balanced, we want to have an even number of ones in each column. This approach helps in explaining the theory, but the first approach is probably easier when you're playing a game. So now let's review our sample game, thinking in terms of balance. Since the game is starting out balanced, we'll consider this from player 2's perspective. Her goal is to make sure the game always stays balanced. Recall the first move we showed player 1 took two markers from the fourth row. When player 2 thinks of each row in terms of powers of 2, she sees that we now have two groups of 4, one group of 2, and three groups of 1. The groups of 1 and 2 are not balanced because there is an odd number of each. Player 2 sees that by removing all of row 2, her new game will be balanced with a pair of 4s and a pair of 1s. Now player 1 removes two markers from row 3. Player 2 examines the game and sees that she has one group of 4, one group of 2, and two groups of 1. So the 4s and 2s are not balanced. She balances this by removing 2 from the last row, leaving a balanced game with two groups of 2 and two groups of 1. Now player 1 takes one marker from row 4, and player 2 puts things back into balance by removing row 3 and wins the game. At this point, you probably have a few questions, but most of them should be answered by the following theorem. It states, first, if a game of Nim is currently balanced, then whatever move your opponent makes will make the game become unbalanced. And second, if a game of Nim is not balanced, there always exists a valid move that will make it balanced again. What this means is once you make the game balanced, you can always force a win. If the game is balanced, anything your opponent does will make it unbalanced. And from this new unbalanced state, you can always do something to make it balanced again. The first statement is fairly easy to prove. If we assume the game is currently balanced and has k rows, then let b1 through bk be the binary representation of each row. That means currently there's an even number of ones in each binary digit position. Suppose the next move is to take markers from some row I, then at least one of the columns that used to have a 1 now has a 0. Otherwise, if all the old ones were still in place, the number can only get bigger or stay the same. Changing this column changes the number of ones from even to odd, so the game is no longer balanced. Rather than getting formal about the second statement, I'll just describe the process. Suppose the game is currently in an unbalanced state. Decide what is the largest power of 2 that is not balanced, and choose a row that has a 1 in that column. Now make a new binary number by switching the 1s and 0s on this row in every column with an odd count. This new number must be smaller than the original because the leading power of 2 column changed from 1 to 0. So the difference between these numbers tells us how many markers to remove from this row. That is, it will change our old binary number into our desired binary number. Let's consider some examples. Suppose we have 5 rows with 1, 3, 5, 3, and 9 markers respectively. We can see from the table that the game is currently not balanced. We have an odd number of 1s, 4s, and 8s. The largest unbalanced power of 2 is 8, so we choose a row that has a 1 in this column. Row 5 is our only choice. Now we flip the binary digits for this row in every unbalanced column. We change the 1 in the 8s column to a 0, change the 0 in the 4s column to a 1. The 2s column is fine, so we leave it 0. And finally change the 1 in the 1s column to a 0. So the number we would like in our last row is 0100, which is just 4. In order to change 9 to 4, we take 5 markers from the last row. Now our rows have 1, 3, 5, 3, and 4 markers, and you can see the game is again balanced. Here's another example. This game currently has 5 rows with 9, 3, 11, 7, and 13 markers. In looking at the table, we can see that the columns for 1s, 2s, and 8s have an odd number of 1s, so that the table is not balanced. The columns for the 8s is the highest power of 2 that's not balanced, so we want to work with one of the 3 rows that have a 1 in this column. Any one of these rows will work. Suppose we choose to work with the first row having 9 markers. We want to toggle the 1s and 0s in every column that's not balanced. In this case, the 4s column is balanced, so it stays the same. But all of the others are flipped. Hence, 1001 changes to 0010, which equals 2. In order to go from 9 markers down to 2, we need to take 7 markers from row 1. This new game will now be balanced. We could just as easily have worked with row 3 with 11 markers. Flipping the bits for everything except the 4s column changes 1011 to 0000, which equals 0. This means if we chose to modify row 3, we must take all 11 markers, leaving 0 markers on this row. And finally, if we'd chosen to work with row 5, having 13 markers, we'd have to change 1101 into 0110, which equals 6. We can go from 13 down to 6 by removing 7 markers from this row. The second part of our theorem is what's referred to as an existence statement. It guarantees that there always exists at least one way to make the game balanced, though as our last example showed, there may be multiple ways to accomplish this. So in summary, the strategy to win our version of NIM is to put the game in a balanced state and then keep it balanced using our bit switching algorithm until your opponent's forced to leave a single row. There are variations of NIM that are more difficult to analyze, but similar in flavor. For instance, you could change the game so that the last person to take a marker loses. Another variation only allows taking at most 1, 2, or 3 markers from a row. And yet another only allows you to select adjacent markers, so choosing markers in the middle of a row would split it into 2 groups. I hope you found this video helpful. You can see more of my math videos at www.mathforeveryone.info. Please feel free to leave comments and suggestions, and thanks for watching. Bye.